Here we have a data log in Google Sheets with an input sheet sidebar on the side here where we can enter in a EV vehicle and then the distance in kilometers that they have traveled and then the charge used and then submit it before it is returned into the data log here. So let me show you 35 and type in 0.02%. And you can see it's been added in the bottom here. Now, we already have some back-end data validation that we completed in the previous tutorial, and you don't need that previous tutorial to continue on here, but if you want to go back, you'll be able to see it up in the top right-hand corner now. In this tutorial, we're going to help out our users a little bit more by providing a bit more front-end validation for them to see where they made their errors live. So take a look at our complete example here. So now we still have got our EV log here, and if the user doesn't put in any values, they'll get an error saying, please fill out this field in the first space where the error occurs. Now, if they put in the wrong value, so for example, if it went -1 kilometer and we hit submit, we get an error value. And we know our EV vehicles don't go any further than 950 kilometers on a charge. So let's put in 1,000 Ks and then we've got a error value there. And let's just make this correct for now. So we'll put in 50 Ks here. And then we've got our charge used. Now that's going to be between 0 and 1%. If we leave this blank for now, we'll get another blank error. We type in 2, we're going to get another error as well when we hit submit. And none of those values are returning back server-side to our Google App script or appearing on a sheet down the bottom. If we type in a low range value, so we say -2, we'll get another error. So it needs to be above 0. And if we put in a good value, we can say 0.025. And everything's working now, we'll hit submit. And we can see that it was success server side and our value has been added into the sheet here. Okay, so let's dive in on how to quickly complete this task. If you want to play along, and I encourage that you do, there is a starter sheet in the description below. So once you have that open and running, let's crack on. So here we are in our Google Sheet. Please go to extensions and app scripts to get into your app script IDE and you'll be here. And you'll probably see the Code.js file first. We won't be working on the Code.js file for this tutorial. We'll be heading straight over to the index.html file and making a few changes here. So the first thing we need to make sure of is that all our input fields are required. So this has to be entered, this one and this field have to be entered before the submit is successful. So you can see here in our select, so that's our drop down menu, we've made it required. And we need to do the same with our other values as well. So we've got another input here. So this is our number in distances. So we need to make this one required as well. And we also need to make our charge required as well. Cool. So the next thing we need to focus on is our distance. So in our distance, we've got this input field here. And instead of keeping it on the one line, let's move this down to a multi-line item. And let's just hit enter, tab, same with the name, distance, and required. And what we need to add here are our ranges. Just for neatness, I'm going to put this below the ID. We can use HTML just to simply add in a min range. And that's going to equal 0. And make sure that 0 is in double quotation marks, not as a number value. And then our max range as well. And that's going to be equal to 950. Now, this will also have the benefit of shrinking down the input box to fit those values in too. So that's going to be great. Okay, so that's our input field handled. And let's go down and do the same for our charge. Now, we've already made a starter on our charge. So let's just put this on a new line. So it's much more readable for us. Same here. Yeah, and yeah. We've already got a step in at the moment, so it can change in values between 0.001 to 0.002 and so on. All we need to do is put in our min and max range, which is our min for a percentage is going to be 0 and our max range is going to be 1. That easy. We've already got required and we've got our steps. Okay, so that's all the HTML formatting we need. So right now we probably won't see anything. So save and go back to our sheet here and we just refresh it or rebuild it. You can see everything's been shrunk down into our sides. If I put in a value that doesn't work, so for example, -1, we're not getting any sort of error indicator in color here. And the same here, if I put in like 3 here, I'm not getting any live indication that there's an error. So let's handle that with a bit of CSS. We've got our container class style here, and just below that, we're just going to type in our input, and we're going to use the invalid pseudo class here, and that CSS will trigger anytime there is an invalid item. And we'll just put in a border every time that occurs. We'll call it border, and we'll make it 2 pixels, dashed, and red. And we'll hit save. Let's head back to our sheet and rebuild the sidebar. And now you can see that the sidebar is appearing with some error handlers here. So that's fantastic. It's exactly what we want. So if we put in 50, it shouldn't do anything to these kilometers. And same if we do 0.5, it should be fine. But if we do something ridiculous like minus 100, it'll come up in red. And the same if we do something like 5, it'll come up in red. Cool. So that's sort of helping the user understand that they're making a mistake there. Only thing at the moment that we're facing is that if we submit this now, it will go server-side to a Google App Script, and our App Script will validate this and make it an error and return it back, as you can see here. But we don't want it to even reach the Google App Script side when the error occurs. So how do we fix that? So let's go back to our Google Sheets, and what we need to do now is just head down to our send input function. Now remember that send input occurs when you click the submit button, and it runs and grabs all the internal form data here. So when this submit button is hit, send input function is triggered, and we need to do something before we go to this Google script run. First we'll grab the form itself. So we'll go const form equals document get element by ID. And what do we want? We want to get the input form. Where am I getting that ID from? So in my form earlier on, we added the ID input form. So let's just cheat and double click that and then whack it in here so we know we don't make a mistake. Okay, cool. So now that we've got the form, let's check any of the items in the form to see if there are any errors existing in it. And to do that, we're going to go const form errors. So we're going to grab the elements from this form. Now, that doesn't produce an array as such, so we need to convert that to an array. So we can use the spread method to do that. So we're going to put in an array here and put in 3 dots, and we're going to call form.elements. And then once we've converted our form elements into an array, we can now iterate through them and filter down to any value that has an error in it. So any value that where the validity is false in it. So now we will go filter. So on each element in our list of elements here, we'll use an arrow function for this. We want the element check validity. And we want to see if that validity equals false. So if there is an error on each of these elements here. And we've got 3 elements. Remember, the first is our select drop-down menu, then our distance input, and then our charge input here. So if that gives us back a list of errors, we know we don't want to continue and send this to the Google App Script server side. So we just want to return the function before we get to this Google script run. So now we can say if form errors dot length. So if this array has a length greater than 0, then there's an error there somewhere. We don't want to send the data back to the Google App Script yet. So we'll go return. So if there are 1 or more errors found, it won't continue on and run the script. Let's hit save and head over and give it a test because we're working on the index.html we need to rebuild. Okay, so now we've got distance in kilometers. Let's make a heinous error here. Minus 100 and 6 here. Okay, so it's showed us in red that there's a bit of a mistake going on here. We select EV Vehicle 4. We're cool there. Let's hit submit. and we've got an error here. We can see nothing's popped up down the bottom to say that it has gone back to the Google Apps script server side and then come back to us with an error, which is good. So let's fix this up now. Let's just keep that one blank this time and see what happens. So we'll hit tab and we'll hit submit. Please fill out this field. Excellent, really handy. Let's put in a value greater than our 950. Hit tab, submit. Value is less than or equal to 950. Very handy, thank you. Okay, so let's put in something reasonable again, 900. And this time we'll make a mistake on this. We'll leave it empty to check. Excellent, please fill out this field. Cool, so it hasn't processed it yet. Minus 4 is a mistake. We'll hit submit. Value must be greater than or equal to 0. Perfect, understood. Let's still be stupid and put in 9 and hit submit. Value must be less than or equal to 1, of course. So we can go 0.9 for 90% charge and hit submit now. And there it is, popped up here, 900Ks, and we've used up 90% charge. Everything's successful and everything's been cleared out for the next input. That's it for building some front-end data validation for your Google Sheets sidebar. As you can see, it can be really helpful for the user experience so they understand where they're making their mistakes. But always remember to make sure you run more strict validation server-side, or in our case, Google Apps script-side. In the next and final tutorial, we're going to cover how to input data from our sidebar into a sheet tab that has been protected by the owner. If you enjoyed this tutorial, please click the like button. And if you want to find out when the next tutorial comes out, please subscribe and hit that notification bell. Until next time.